were you on the night of July 27th? Turns out the very act of remembering might make you forget, and that's not a bad thing. Hey guys, Julie here for D News. Scientists have known for a while that humans have terrible memories. Memories can change over time, and we can even remember things that never happened. We've talked a bunch about this on the show. Check out some links in the description below for those episodes. So we know memory sucks, but science hasn't been sure why we forget things at all. Is it a passive thing that just happens? Well, it turns out that forgetting is a pretty active process. Your brain does it on purpose and in a couple of different ways. New research published in the journal Nature Neuroscience found that by actively recalling an event, related memories might be forgotten. The researchers asked participants to look at images and to recall them several times. MRI scans revealed that as the participants remembered the images, competing memories initially fired up too, but then they became suppressed. And that might be a good thing. I mean, that way when I talk about, you know, for example, China from a dinner party, you don't immediately think of the country China. The researchers think that maybe these new findings might be incredibly useful when trying to overcome a negative memory from our past. So forgetting might be a good thing. It actually might make us remember other memories. But how does that happen? What's going on in the brain? Another study published in the journal Cell found a specific protein that might be responsible for forgetting. The so-called Musashi protein helps build connections between neurons called synapses, where information is passed between them. The researchers genetically modified ringworms to not produce this protein. Both regular and modified ringworms seemed to learn the same, but over time, the Musashi-less worms remembered better. The researchers think the protein aids in forgetting by stopping the stabilization of synaptic connections. Basically, when you learn something new, new connections are made between neurons. Some proteins make these connections strong and more stable, but this Musashi protein actively disrupts this process, making the ringworms and maybe other animals forgetful. The researchers think this might help the nervous system retain its plasticity, and that if you don't, you might develop serious mental disorders. Another study published in the journal Neuron found that right as we form a memory, we are also forgetting it. The study looked at brains in fruit flies to see how it works. They found that dopamine helps form a memory and also helps us forget it. Dopamine is a neurotransmitter that does a lot of things. It does things with reward, pleasure, and learning. The researchers found that as dopamine is released in the brain, it acts first on one receptor called DDA1, which helps memories form. After a memory solidifies, dopamine is still being released, but this time it acts on another receptor called DAMB, which starts to chip away at the memory unless something significant is attached to it. In the case of the flies, this might be a sweet smell or an electric shock. The process of solidifying a memory from a short term to a long term is called consolidation. For us, that special thing might be an emotion. The researchers think this mechanism might be why savants have such extraordinary memories. Maybe it's not that they have better memories, but that they have worse forgetting mechanisms. And that could be beneficial. It might make us remember the more important things and keep us from being overwhelmed by the bad things and the not so important things like certain exes. Anyways, before we go on a trip down memory lane, do you love D News? We want to hear from you. We've got a quick survey. It'll take just 2 minutes. It's the first link in the description down below. It would really help us. We want to know what you think about our show, and we want to make the best show we possibly can. So please go ahead, click that link, fill out the survey. We'd love you for it. So, do you have any memories you'd rather forget? Let us know in the comments below. And while you're at it, don't forget to hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week.